Darnell, can you kind of just take us through the summer that's been for you so far? What have you been up to this off season? And what's you mentioned golf, but what else has been kind of occupying your time this summer?
Well, obviously, I went to the World Championships. So that took up a month. It's always a fun experience to go over there and play for Canada. We had a great group of guys, great coaching staff. That's a lot of fun to be a part of each and every time you have the opportunity to be there. And got to go to Italy after that. Went to Florence for 2 days, to Rome for 2 days, met up with a couple of my buddies from Hamilton, and just spent 4 days in Italy, and it was so much fun. I think I've never eaten that much food in my life, and definitely plan on going back. I don't think I ate enough pizza.
For sure. And then a little bit on the family side of things. So with your sister, she's obviously a WNBA All-Star with the New York Liberty. I just wanted to ask you, as two pro athletes in the same family, I'm sure you got a pretty big proud brother feeling right now for her.
Oh, absolutely. We actually, it was announced, I think last week, we actually went and saw her play in Chicago, just after it was announced. So it was obviously, she called us the night before it was announced and told us that she was going to be a starter on the WNBA All-Star team. And it was obviously such a proud brother moment, but the proud family moment. Everyone's looking forward to the game, obviously, and then spending some family time together, going to Vegas and celebrating and watching the game. So it'll be a lot of fun and heavily supported by our family.
Mm-hmm. And what's it been like just for you guys, kind of, you look on social media, on Twitter and stuff, you guys are always kind of pumping each other's tires a bit. What has that kind of been like just sharing with that journey over the last few years, just both being professional athletes?
Yeah, it's a lot of fun. It's a lot of, there's a lot of proud moments just like that to the WNBA selection. There's a lot of proud moments to celebrate and follow along. That's kind of the cool part about social media. Is, even if I don't watch a game, I can, look up and see, her, whether her stat line or if she made any really cool plays over the course of a game. It's really fun just to be a fan and be able to watch, obviously, her growth throughout her first 2 years here in the WNBA, but also, how much fun she has with it.
And you mentioned Europe, but you're spending your off seasons in Hamilton or in Ontario there. In terms of training, are you focusing on anything specific this year, or any certain players that you've worked with in the past that you continue to work with this summer?
Yeah, I'm in Toronto all summer. Get the opportunity to work out with Matt Nichol, and we have a great group of guys at the gym. Jared McCann, Tyler Seguin, Devontae Smith, Pelly. The list kind of just goes on of guys that have worked out at the gym or pop in and work out with us on different days. It's been a lot of fun, a lot of growth each and every year. Matty obviously pushes us to new limits. For me, I want to continue to be an explosive player and be someone who can get up and down the ice, fast and in effective ways. As well as I'm a nice worker, with Adam Oates, so kind of just continuing to build off some of the things that have helped me grow my game so far, and I'll take my game to another level.
Mm-hmm. And there's been a couple changes in Edmonton with a new general manager and head coach, Ken Holland and Dave Tippett. Just what are your kind of first impressions of the executives and the head coach, and how that's going to kind of change the dynamic next season?
Yeah, everyone's excited, obviously, when you have, starting at the top with Ken. You have someone who has obviously seen all different types of, facets within an organization, whether it's, an older, established veteran team, a younger team that's evolving. He's seen basically everything. And for us, you see it as a huge advantage. And, we're really looking forward to, the opportunity that we have at hand with coming back to camp next year with a lot of familiar faces that our relationships continue to grow. We continue to build that kind of brotherhood amongst each other. And then with our coaches You know, obviously, Coach Tip has had success in the league, and you know, you talk to everyone who's played for him. And, you know, usually you talk to guys, and you never get a full. You know, everyone likes the guy, but you know, with our coach, Dave, it's everyone you talk to is love playing for him and love their experience playing for him. And, you know, as a player, it really, really excites you to get the season going and to get to camp and start to work on our game. I think he, you know, the way his teams in the past have checked and played a solid five all over the ice mentality, it should go great with kind of the players that we have and the team that we have. And, I think everyone's just kind of has that excitement of getting the summer over and just getting back to work.
Mm-hmm. And you mentioned camp. Maybe just finally kind of talk about the new faces that you guys have coming into the fold this year. More specifically for you, just how do you kind of evaluate that depth of talent coming through on defense this year?
Yeah, obviously, even, you know, we have a lot of good young D-men, you know, whether they're just drafted or been playing in the minors or in junior. You know, we have a lot of really good young D-men that, you know, it's exciting. You get to camp, there's a lot of competition, and it's you know, it's a lot of fun. It's a lot of fun as a D-man to, you know, get to camp and know that you know, really the, you know, our farm system and, you know, the way the team's drafted, you know, we continue to get better and better, and you know, there's a lot of buzz around our team and what we can be, you know, prospect wise. That especially is true within the D core, the young guys coming up, whether it's the Boosh, Bearsy, you know, we just drafted Phillip. There's a lot of really, really good talent that we have, so it's exciting.